We would like to welcome to the stage the governor, Mitt Romney.
Hey, gentlemen, boy, is this exciting. What a time for our state, for the whole region, for the Red Sox Nation. These guys are fabulous. They've wakened up a spirit that's been dormant for a long time, a spirit of we can win this thing. I just can't get over how exciting it is for our guys to have done what they've done for Massachusetts, for Boston, and for the Red Sox Nation everywhere.
For us, I think it has taken a little while to sink in. I think it is starting now to sink in for you. Has it sunk in yet? The Red Sox are world champions.
You know, the truth of the matter is that we were watching the game on TV, and it was eighth inning. We said, you know, can it possibly happen? We went outside to see the eclipse, and if you went out and looked at the eclipse, you saw that the shadow of the earth was blocking off some of the rays of the sun on the moon, and the moon was turning red. And Ann said, you know, it may just happen. It happened. The curse is gone, I believe.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Good
right.
With you this morning.
Right. Thank you very much. There are some special people that will be joining us here on the stage, but two very special people about to join us. The general manager of the Boston Red Sox, Theo Epstein, and manager, Terry Francona.
Oh, you guys have notes.
Theo, we have notes. You have no notes. First of all, to be here and be back in Red Sox Nation again, we spoke after you guys had won the championship. Now you're back here amongst Red Sox Nation.
It's great. You know, it was, that ride in from Logan was one of the best feelings of our lives, getting to just ride in the buses, and everyone was on their way to work. They stopped, got out of their cars, and waved at us, and it was like the whole city's got a big smile on. It's awesome.
Terry, it's been quite a group you had to handle here all season long, a fun-loving group, but a group that went out every day and played the game of baseball the way it's supposed to be played.
You know what? They're awesome. They may not wear their hair normal, and they may not dress normal, but they play the game about as good as you can. For that, we should all be proud of them.
Theo, could you talk about how special this group has been from the beginning? I mean, not just the playoffs and the way they came back down 3-0 to the Yankees, but really all season long.
Yeah, you know, we faced a lot of adversity. We thought we had a great team coming out of spring training, had some injuries, didn't play well for a while, and it just comes down to what's inside each of these guys' heart. They dug deep and got hot the last 2 months of the season, and I'm still cautiously optimistic things are going to work out this year.
How special is it to be able to share it with these people as well, to come home and have something like this?
Well, you just asked me that. There's no place we'd rather be. I mean, to bring this thing home to these people, that's why we went out to St. Louis in the first place.
One thing I can tell you is the manager hasn't slept since February. You going to get a good night's sleep one of these days,
Rem, one of these days, but not yet. Got to have some partying to do.
Enjoy the day. You deserve it.
Gentlemen, thank you. Thank you very much. Up next, the elder statesman of the Boston Red Sox with the longest tenure. Please welcome Tim Wakefield.
Thank you.
Tim, being here with the Red Sox for the longest amount of time, having last year occur to the Red Sox and to come back this year, this has to be especially special for you.
It's unbelievable. You know, after beating the Yankees in Game 7, I got to stand on that mound that I had to walk off of last year, a loser, and I got to stand on that mound, a winner. And, thank you. And then to win four more games in a row was the most unbelievable thing I've ever been a part of.
Tim, you had tears in your eyes after the last game. You've been here longer than any other member of the Red Sox. You've seen a lot of things throughout your career here. I don't know if this can't be possibly topped.
It can't be, you know, going through, I haven't gone through as much heartache as some of you guys have, but I've been here a long time and really felt your pain. But I tell you what, those were big tears of joy coming down my face after game four in St. Louis. And I'm just proud to call myself a Red Sox.
How about this group of guys? You guys never get down. You were down in the series 3-0, but never gave up.
Yeah, you know, our philosophy after being down games 3-0 was just win today. And amazing. I got to give credit to Tito and his coaching staff to instill that in our brains and just win today. And we just kept winning today, and we won 8 in a row.
You walked up to your manager against the Yankees. You said, give me the baseball to save the rest of the bullpen. That's the way you've been your whole career.
Yeah, I've always had a lot of pride in having my spikes on every single day. And, you know, I know we were running into trouble there in game three. And, you know, we just had to try to save the bullpen for the day because I knew if we won the next day, we had a real good chance of winning.
Tim, enjoy the day.
Thank you.
All right.
We're going to take a look at some highlights from this season. An incredible season it was. The world champion Boston Red Sox.
Cabrera off balance, the throw gets there. Up the middle, Pokey Reese ranging, throwing, in time to get him at first. There's Bill Miller on the run, and in time, nicely done. Berkevich will be tested as he touches second and fires to first. How about that? Ten punchados for Pedro Martinez and a complete game.
Welcome back inside Fenway Park as we celebrate the world champion Boston Red Sox presented by Bank of America. We are joined by the heart and soul of the Red Sox, Jason Veritek. How sweet is this, Jason?
I actually just walked out of the clubhouse for the first time, so I'm a little shocked right now.
Yesterday you had the chance to celebrate with Red Sox fans. What's it been like to be back here in the nation and to celebrate with these fans again?
We're just really looking forward to today. I'm really seeing our teammates and getting to see everybody in a much more relaxed atmosphere. We haven't had that opportunity yet.
Jason, the feeling after the final out?
Relief. I was really relieved, but so proud. So proud of this entire team. Everything we went through, and then proud and just, I remember Kevin and I taking a moment just because we just couldn't believe how much time has been put by lots of people to achieve that, but all the years that people have suffered is a big difference.
And you mentioned yesterday, next year when they walk into Yankee Stadium, you walk in with your head held high.
Every Red Sox fan from now on can always walk into Yankee Stadium with their heads up.
Jason, thank you. Enjoy the parade. Thank you very much for joining us.